What are unsigned integers? Well, there's really two answers to that question. The first answer focuses on a mathematical understanding. Specifically, unsigned integers are non-negative whole numbers. In math, we actually have a bunch of different ways to write popular sets of numbers. Generally, the most basic is called the natural numbers, but in the United States, and in fact, anywhere that's not France, we say that natural numbers start at 1 and go up to infinity. So these are the counting numbers that start at 1. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Then normally we think about integers in general, which is the set Z. Those are all positive and negative counting numbers. So 0, negative 1, 1, negative 2, 2, negative 3, 3, et cetera, et cetera. However, in computer science, because of the idea of encoding numbers using binary representations, we're going to talk a lot about that in this lesson. It is really, really helpful to have a special set that includes the positive counting numbers as well as zero. Computer scientists call these the unsigned integers. So unsigned integers are non-negative integers. In other words, they're the natural numbers as well as the number zero. Signed integers, on the other hand, are both positive, negative, and zero whole numbers. The answer that I just gave is what I would call the mathematician's answer to the question, what are unsigned integers? But of course, this is a class about MATLAB and coding. I would be remiss if I just said that is the only answer to that question. And in fact, in MATLAB, unsigned integers have a very, very special meaning. Let's go up to the documentation search bar and type in data types and then push enter. Let's go in this case down to the second result, which is numeric arrays, characters, strings, etc. That pulls up the exact same discussion that we've seen previously. We're going to click on Fundamental MATLAB Classes. Remember, this diagram describes 16 array-based classes in MATLAB and also one scalar-based class. The scalar-based class is called function handles. The array-based class, actually, there are 7 different categories: logical, string, char, character, numeric, table, cell, and structure. In this category called numeric, there are actually 10 different fundamental data classes that we offer. Here in this diagram, we see that those are int8, int16, int32, int64, uint8, uint16, uint32, uint64, and then 2 floating point classes called single and double. The reason that I highlight this is to reiterate many, many times that one of the best ways that you can learn MATLAB is actually to teach yourself MATLAB by reading documentation. But the other reason is because we're asking ourselves this question, what are unsigned integers? And my claim is this set of 4 different data classes are really MATLAB's representation of unsigned integers using native numeric data. Now, if we take that help documentation that we were just looking at and translate it into our own table, that's exactly what I've done here. On the left-hand side, we have the name of our 16 classes, and on the right-hand side, we have a short description. With this in mind, I would say that unsigned integers in MATLAB are a collection of data classes that allow us to encode unsigned integers, in other words, non-negative integers, using various sizes of data. In MATLAB, there are 4 unsigned integer classes, that is uint8, uint16, uint32, and uint64. The acronym UINT stands for unsigned integer, and then the number 8, 16, 32, 64 indicates the number of bits dedicated to that data class. So UINT8 represents unsigned integers stored using 8 bits of memory. Similarly, UINT32 encodes unsigned integer data with 32 bits of memory. In this lesson, we're going to see how to use the uint8, uint16, uint32, and uint64 functions to convert variables that are stored using the double data class into variables that are stored using an unsigned integer data class. We'll also talk about memory requirements and many other features of unsigned integer data that we can take advantage of in MATLAB. So from that perspective, when we're thinking about unsigned integers in mathematics, unsigned integers are this large set of possible non-negative counting numbers. But in MATLAB, unsigned integers represent numeric data stored in a special data class. And specifically, there are 4 unsigned integer data classes of varying sizes: 8 bits, 16 bits, 32 bits, and 64 bits. The real key for us to figure out what's going on with MATLAB's numeric data is to really figure out what's going on beneath the hood with this unsigned integer class, and what are the features, strengths, and weaknesses of each of these unsigned integer data classes so that we know when and how we should use these versus other numeric data classes in MATLAB. This lesson is designed to give us deep insights into that question and set the foundation for really understanding what's going on with the double data class, which really sets the foundation for modern day numerical analysis on binary computation machines. By the end of this unit on introduction to numerical analysis, I expect that you, my viewers, will actually understand all of these data classes, the strengths and weaknesses, and be able to strategically choose which data class you want to use based on the programming assignment that you're working on, because you will actually understand a lot of what's going on under the hood in MATLAB, and you'll be able to take advantage of some of the structures that MATLAB offers in each of these numeric data classes. So if someone asks you the question, what are unsigned integers? I would encourage you to ask them back, well, what do you mean? Do you mean from a mathematical standpoint, or do you mean from a programming standpoint? In a mathematical standpoint, unsigned integers is a set of non-negative counting numbers. So 0, 1, 2, 3, all the way up to infinity. In a programming standpoint or a computation standpoint, unsigned integers represent special data classes used to encode and save unsigned integer values as variables in our computer programming language. In MATLAB, there are four classes, and we see those listed here. For the rest of the videos in this lesson, we're going to start to peel back the layers behind what unsigned integers are and how to use those data classes in MATLAB to our advantage. I always welcome your questions, comments, and concerns in the comment section below, and I will see you in the next video.